So now we're going to be counting Malchut of Gevurah. We are concluding the week of Gevurah. In the beginning, we had the first week during Pesach, a week of love and chesed and kindness. Then we moved to the week of Gevurah. And now we are concluding. The whole week we were talking about this strength within me. Yesterday I was saying that the strength is hidden and everybody has this powerful Gevurah in them, that the majority of people don't even know their capabilities. The majority of people don't even know how much strength they have. Very sad, you see many people that in their 60s, 70s and 80s, that's when they figure out what's their strength. And I'm saying very sad because you want to figure that out as soon as possible. Doesn't matter right now, it's never too late, of course. I know people who do tshuva in their 70s and 80s. But nevertheless, you want to come very quickly to understand what is my strength. And the only reason is because I need to give it over to the world. And here I'm using the word strength, but we can use other words such as talents, such as gifts, such as certain things that you really, really love to do and you're really, really good at. You can title it however you want, but when Hashem gave you a certain gift, it's not for you, it's to give it out. And doesn't matter what it is, even if you are an amazing gardener, you can be an amazing carpenter, you can be an artist, a singer, a writer, it doesn't matter what it is. There's no such a thing that the person doesn't have a certain gift. So this week we're calling it Gevurah, it's a strength, it's a gift. Now what do I do with it? Malchut sheba Gevurah is that I know how to give it over to somebody else if somebody else needs to benefit from it. If somebody is not benefiting from my gift, I'm the one who's failing. So when you're looking at it, we spoke about it last week, and I said that every person is a king. But what's called Bezeir Anpin, a mini king, not a king of the country or a king of a land. Zeir Anpin means a mini, a small thing. What does it mean? In my home, I'm the king of the home, right? There's no other husband in the home. I am the man in the home, let's hope. And then there's the wife and the kids. And in my congregation, I might be the rabbi of the congregation. And in the class, I'm the teacher. And in the business, I'm the boss, or I'm the manager, or whatever it is. But everybody is a king in a Zeir Anpin, in a small way. What does it mean? It means that people depend on me. It means that people need me. Either my kids need me. A lot of people say, listen, if you are a president of a big company, I understand thousands of people depend on you. You're a great general, whatever it is. But what if I'm a simple individual, I'm a mother for three kids, I'm a father that just goes to work in the morning. Even if one person is depending on you, you're already a king. The reality is, whether you acknowledge it or not, many people depend on you. It doesn't have to be your kids, it doesn't have to be your workers, it can be even your neighbors and people that depend on you to give them charity, to teach them, to help them, to give them some time a day, whatever it is. So the point is that many, many people depend on me, whether you acknowledge it or not. When they depend on me, they can depend on me financially, emotionally, physically, whatever it is, but many people are looking at you and they waiting for you to do something, to help them, to give them a smile. Sometimes it's a little kid who just needs you to smile to them. Which means, in other words, that I have responsibility. And it's not the quantity, it's the quality. Somebody, they might laugh by seeing the video. Somebody sent me a message. If I rather affect a few people, but very, very strong, or affect a lot of people, but not so much. You can't do both. You can be both things. Some mentors, rabbis, whatever it is, will choose to affect. I'm only affecting the 10 students around me, but I'm giving them all I have. And then I'm affecting them in a very profound way. Some will say, no, I can't. I don't go for 10 students. I have 50,000 students. I don't even know the majority of them. But nevertheless, I shoot to all directions and many people get affected, but they're affected not in such a profound way. So somebody sent me that message. What do I prefer? I think the person was trying to get me to say, yeah, a few people, and okay, now be my personal trainer. But nevertheless, it's not the quantity, it's the quality. It doesn't matter how many people depend on you, even if it's one person. But nevertheless, you have responsibility. with this great power, I need to be able to give what I'm supposed to. This is the Malchut Shebegvurah. The Malchut is the fact that I am the king. We're calling it the king. Don't imagine now the crown. I'm king. A king is a giver. If you remember, for example, a great king in our history is Yosef HaTzadik. What was Yosef HaTzadik? He was a mashbir. He used to give people sustenance, food, everything. That's a king. Maybe in our generation, a king is just the one who takes. But really, a real king, look at David HaMelech, look at Moshe Rabbeinu. Moshe Rabbeinu was also a king, even though we call him Rabbeinu, but he was a king. He was the king of Eretz Yisrael, of the nation of Israel. So we had many, many kings, but if you're looking at the successful kings in our history, they're givers, they're not takers. David HaMelech didn't come to take anything. David HaMelech was so humble, his entire essence was just giving. That's what I'm talking about, a king. So when I have this responsibility, I am the king. This is the Malchut. How do I apply that? Is with Gevurah. What's the Gevurah? Is the strength that is in me. Sometimes I know of a mother, she's a single mother, and Hashem should help her to have an easy life, but she has a very hard life. Providing to the kids and educating them, working a full-time job, but coming home and cleaning and washing and bathing and preparing. And this is one thing that one can say, okay, but simultaneously she has to deal with an extremely annoying ex-husband, extremely annoying boss, extremely annoying this, and I know her plate is not full, it's already overflowing. So, but nevertheless, she cannot break down for the kids. What's holding her strong is, I have the kids. I cannot now completely give up and say I can. Why? The kids are depending on her. This is Malchut Shebegvurah, that you are the king. You are, in this case, will be a queen, but has to be with strength. Why? Because these little neshamot are depending on her. She'll be weak, they'll be affected. She'll be strong, she has to put on a smile when they look up at her. So I have to understand, this is what I'm calling with Zeir Anpin, because we all have that in one way or another. Sometimes I can be on the verge of collapsing, but if I don't put out this smile to my kid in the morning, don't worry honey, everything will be okay. The kid doesn't need to know about the problems in the house, in some cases. But nevertheless, in order for me to provide the needs of others, I need a lot of strength. What is my strength is what Hashem gave me. And of course, the Malchut here means that I am the one, I am the giver here. So Malchut Shebegvurah is the power to give good to another person. I will say it in Lashon Kodesh, it will be more clear. Hakoach le'ashpi atov lazulat. The power, the energy, the ability to give something good to somebody else. And doesn't matter if that somebody else is my wife or a total stranger in the street. This is Malchut Shebegvurah. The Gevurah will allow me, will give me the ability to be the king and to give something over. A lot of people, they have a lot to give. They don't know how to give it. A person can be an amazing individual, but they don't know how to give their child anything. Why? Because maybe their opinions are old-fashioned opinions, or they just don't know how to relate with a child. It's very easy to relate with somebody when that person is like me. Now try to relate with somebody that is not like you. Which means, if you want to be a mashpia, a giver, there's only one way of doing it. When you lower yourself to the level of the receiver. If I want to give something to my child, I can't stand up full height and point a finger. I need to go down to the level of my child, to eye to eye, to give him what he needs. So, Malchut Shebegvurah is allowing me to reveal this inner strength in me in order for me to give to somebody else. And again, this Malchut, this is the Melech. This is where I'm becoming a king. Like I said before, a king is a giver. For example, Yosef HaTzadik, Moshe Rabbeinu, David HaMelech, and so forth. The act that I want to apply, when I want to practice this, is, first of all, I have to understand and remember the foundation here that, first of all, you have to find out what's your gifts, what's your talents, what's your gevurah, what's your strength. If you don't know that yet, then go on a quest and find it out. And like I told you, you don't need to be the best musician in the world or a great artist. Sometimes it can be something that you can't even imagine. Well, that's my strength? Yeah, that's your strength. Sometimes your strength is your kindness. Sometimes your strength is your ability to create things, to help somebody, to give hope to somebody, to teach somebody a job, whatever it is. Everybody has something. And like I said, I totally disagree that there's no such a thing that a person doesn't have a gift or a talent. You just have to find it. Now, if you're smart, you empower it and you nourish it. Then it becomes strong. Then you have to bring it out to the surface so you can start giving it to people. Because if you have a talent and you're not giving it to other people and you're not doing good in the world with what Hashem gave you, sorry to tell you, you are a waste of time in the world. Hashem kivyachol will tell you, what are you doing? I gave you an ability. Well, why aren't you doing anything with it? It's even worse when I take this ability and I use it for something negative. That's what a lot of people do. They might be extremely sharp in their mind, very smart individual. They'll use it to cheat in business and to make a lot of money one way or another. That's not what Hashem gave you, wisdom. So, or like I told you one time, a person can be a genius programmer and he can build unbelievable programs that will assist people or build all sorts of programs that will hack into system and destroy things. So you have the power where you're taking this power. So this is, first of all, the most important thing. But practically saying, when I want to apply it in my life, if I am a mashpia, a giver to somebody else, and there's no such a thing, unless you somehow live on a deserted island, that nobody will get anything from you, then there's in Hebrew it's called ma'agal hashpa'ah, the circle around me that is affected by me. And I'll give you an example how sometimes it's misused. Sometimes can be a parent that his circle of influence is his wife and kids and his co-workers, but the person is so miserable, so negative, that everybody, the shefa that they're getting, the energy that they're getting from him is evil, bad, and sad, and aggressive, and he's not doing anything good. The father walks in, starts screaming here, punching here, pushing here, affecting everything in the bad way. So there is always a circle around me that is affected by my actions. Needless to say, not even a question to say, you have to be careful that the circle around you doesn't get affected because of your deficiencies. If I'm upset, doesn't mean that my wife has to be a punching bag. If I had a bad day, doesn't mean that my kid needs to suffer. If I have going through some type of a trouble, doesn't mean that the person who's sitting next to me has to be insulted because I have a problem. This is the first thing. But nevertheless, the circle that is around me, and I couldn't find the right term in English. In Hebrew, it's called ma'agal hashpa'ah. Ma'agal means a circle around me, and it doesn't matter what I'm going to do. People are going to be affected, good or bad. So the people around me, I need to understand that I affect them. I need to focus and to say, how am I affecting this person? How am I affecting this person? How am I affecting this person in my life? It can be my wife, my mother, my father, my kids, my neighbor, my coworker, it doesn't matter. And am I really affecting them how I'm supposed to? Or am I finding loopholes and excuses how to get away from it? I know many parents that are good-hearted parents, but they don't give in 1 minute to their children. Not for anything. So are you giving the right effect to your child or not? The fact that you're giving the child a place to live, food and clothing, doesn't mean that you're giving them what they need. They might need attention, they might need love, they might need a father to play basketball with them or whatever it is. So the practical exercise you want to do is you look at your circle around you and you start looking one person after the other and you ask yourself, am I giving that person what I'm supposed to give that person? Or am I hiding behind some excuse that I don't feel like doing it right now to this person? And again, it's very much connected to Yesod of Malchut. Bechlal, we know that Yesod and Malchut are constantly connected. They're, one after the other. But not only that, even Kabbalistically looking at it, the Yesod is the funnel, so to say, the basin that is holding, not the foundation, rather the funnel where it's holding all the Shefa that's coming from all the Sefirot. I like calling it a basin. Basin is like the basis. That all the Shefa that is coming from Chesed, Gvura, Tiferet, Netzach, Hod, Yesod, it goes to Yesod, and then the Yesod gives it over to the Malchut. Funnel is כמו צינור של שפע. כל השפע הוא מגיע למקום אחד. All the Shefa comes to the Yesod. And the Yesod is the one who will give it over to the Malchut. So in both cases we see that it's all about the Esod is going to allow me to build, the Esod Sheba Malchut, sorry, will allow me to build this connection now. Now, when I already have the connection, how am I nourishing it? And I need to understand the connection is not only my wife, it can be the person in the street that I meet once a day or once a week or once in my lifetime. But in any type of encounter that I have, must be that it has to be some type of exchange of energy. And I have to understand, how am I affecting on the people around me? Am I giving 100% of me? Don't add into that equation that what am I getting? It's nothing to do with what you're getting. It has to do with what you're giving. In any type of correspondence between two sides, it's not about what you're getting from here. If you're coming to, and the approach is, what is in it for me? That's the number one mistake. It's already going to be, this is the recipe for failure. So in any relationship, especially when I'm practicing what we're talking about now, the Malchut Sheba Gevurah, how am I giving from myself to you, 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 and you? You cannot come with any thoughts of what am I going to gain from here? But he's not doing it back. He's not giving me anything. So again, you have to come with a title. It's not about you. It's about you giving to the other person. That's how you practically apply that. And you want to start looking in any relationship in your life, close ones and distant ones, and question yourself, am I really giving everything that I have to give to that person? And you know what? You have to be also smart to say, okay, this is how much I can give. You can't be drawn and being, so to say, sucked completely in many relationships. The receiver will see, oh, I'm getting a good freebie here, a good dose here. Let me take advantage of that.
So you ask, giving, if you're giving in order to receive, like you expect.
Exactly.
Something.
If you're giving in order to receive, then it's not giving. Yeah. How do you call it?
There's a business deal, like
not a business deal, but there's a
interest.
An interest, a condition. No, there's a ulterior motive.
Ulterior motive, right? Exactly.
If you're just giving, then you're a giver, and this is bemet the Malchut Sheba Gevurah. And again, like I said before, for us being in Israel, this is very applicable to this week's parasha, Ahavta Lecha Kamocha, that you love another person with no conditions, with no asking questions, and with not looking for the faults. Very easy to look for the faults. We're going to see now in the next class how the Chesed Sheba Tiferet is the next one in line. You'll see very soon the connection, how Malchut Sheba Gevurah, it may be the end of the week of Gevurah, but it's totally connected to the beginning of next week, which will be the Chesed of Tiferet, and you'll see very soon the connection between them. And Bezal Hashem, Bemet, we should have the ability to not only apply that in theory, but apply practically, how am I affecting another person's life? And that's really my purpose of creation, to be a giver, to be a mashpia, to change another person's life. By default, when that's what I do, when that's my motion, my needs are going to be taken care of. I might not get what I want from the person that I'm giving. I will probably get it from somebody else. Hashem will take care of my needs. My interest is how am I taking care of another person's needs. This is the easiest way to explain Malchut Sheba Gevurah. And I'm taking the strength in me and I'm becoming a king or a queen and I'm able to give it out. And trust me, not Yosef HaTzadik, not David HaMelech, not Moshe. Nobody ever came and says, what are you bringing me? Think that any time David HaMelech approached him and says, what, you owe me something? I gave you? No. A king, you just give. And by default, you're becoming the channel that Hashem is giving you in order to give. Then, by the way, the more you give, the more you'll get from Hashem to give. Whether it's money, energy, thoughts, power, whatever it is. You keep something for yourself, then not only that you're not going to get more, you're losing by not giving, and you're not replenishing your arsenals, your spiritual and emotional arsenals. Zad Hashem should have a very successful week to conclude the Sefirah of Gevurah.